Well, we've taken a look at what that team needed to do to accomplish that 1995 national title win. But what about the legacy of that game? The University of Montana, once known for its basketball programs, now was known for football after the national title win propelled the program into the upper echelon of the FCS and NCAA.
As you get older, you start to realize that and as you go back and people still come up to you and your kids kind of look at you like, you know, why are they talking to you, Dad? You know, you realize you did have a part in something pretty special.
In the years before the 1995 football title, the main shows on campus were Grizz and Lady Grizz basketball games, with the Mike Montgomery and Stu Morrill eras for the men and the dominant Robin Selvig years for the ladies. However, while basketball is still a force here at UM, Grizz football became the main show on campus and across the state of Montana.
Don Reed has a lot to do with that. I mean, mid-80s, he came in and, you know, we had really, I think we had the fan support and the backing of our alumni that we wanted to build something, but who had the vision and who had the plan? I think it was Don.
That victory not only changed the perception of Grizz football in the state, but on the national scale as well.
It's fun because even when I meet other people, you know, just around the country, and I'll say where I'm from, a lot of people, even at bigger schools, have heard of Montana, the University of Montana, and their football team.
While the players were young, they knew they had accomplished something special that would stand forever.
You know, the President of the United States, Bill Clinton, is calling Coach Reed and Dave. And so, you know, it's a little surreal. But, yeah, you know that this is a big deal. And the amount of people showing up for, you know, when we got off the plane.
Following that win, Montana went on to win the Big Sky Conference 13 of the next 14 years. In 2001, the Grizzlies were back on top as they won their second national title.
Having gone to several games throughout the years and just watched it progress and the stadium get bigger and bigger and bigger, you certainly know that you had a part in that.
That was something that we were trying to establish, try and put Montana on the map as a national powerhouse, and to know that our team sort of picked up where previous teams had left off and we were able to really achieve that goal and maybe hopefully set the program up for further success it means the world to me as a Missoula kid who grew up watching the Grizz.
The Grizz made it to the title game three more times in that decade with appearances in 2004, 2008, and 2009, but failed to bring home the trophy. Now 25 years since that championship, and the Grizz haven't reached a title game since that loss in 2009. While it's been over a decade since an appearance, the reputation still stands at the FCS level. The Grizz just need to find that magic once again.
I think it has continued. I think I'm really happy Bobby Houck's back. I think that's to me, that's fits. That's what Montana is.
Kind of stuck, and you know, even though they haven't had the success, they're still considered, you know, a powerhouse. And you know, in a few games here or there, and they're right back in it.
In Missoula, Jack Ginsburg, MTN Sports.